Jeg selv, italiener, kom til Norge og fant ikke noe arbeid. Mine kamerater, mine medarbeidere, de forsøkte å komme inn på teaterskolen og kom ikke inn fordi de ikke hadde talent. Det viste seg at omstendighetene var ikke til rette for oss. Så det var nødvendig at vi selv skulle skape disse omstendighetene. Derfor skapte vi Odin Teatret.
Odin Theatre first performed more than 50 years ago in Norway. Their performance was completely different from what the theatre audiences were accustomed to. It was something entirely new. Over the years, Odin Theatre's desire to explore and to find new ways of artistic expression, combined with their hard work and consistency, both in study and in training, opened a new chapter in theatre and made Odin an important name.
At the beginning, I was only expecting obstinacy, endurance by my actors. They had been refused from theatre school, just like me, had been refused by the theatrical milieu. So we knew that we didn't have the necessary qualification for being theatre people. And therefore, I didn't look to what one can call talent or good voice or agility in movements. What I was interested was, is this young person, has he this stamina, it has a sort of will to fight against the difficulties.
I was 20 years old when I started to work with Eugenio Barba in Oslo, Norway. And my colleague, Torgeir, he was only 17.
Kongen og dronningen er ikke vel.
He left us some years ago because of a cancer.
Hva vil du gjøre?
Spørre litt, foreslå.
Om de samler seg imot deg.
I was not interested in theatre, really. I thought theatre was so boring. The only good thing was we went in a bus and we had sweets on the way. But so they said, there's coming this Norwegian group. It was this very small group of actors, and they came to a high school. And it was from the moment they came in, the actors, I was just blown away. It was like their bodies were transparent. It was like a completely new language. It had nothing to do with the theatre I'd seen before. They were making a tour, and they were offered to come here to Holstebro and to stay in 1966.
After the two first years in Norway, we came here to Denmark, where, as you know, it was this old farm that was transformed into a theater.
So they were making a tour, and they were offered to come here to Holstebro and to stay in 1966. So she said, yes, maybe the group will come to Denmark, the director of the school. And I said, yeah, I want to go.
The first thing that I was very curious about was how they were exploring life on stage, creating completely new forms of drama. I liked the non-verbal thing, although they did a lot of text, but they were speaking in different Scandinavian languages.
We had been moving from Norway to Denmark, so my Norwegian actors could not be understood by the Danish spectators. And other young people came from many countries. So we were a theater company where we had not a common language, we actors and director, and we could not share the same language with our spectators. And this obliged to a form to find expressive ways of communication which characterize Odin Theatre's performances.
In search of a shared language, Odin Theatre have found new ways of expression through body and voice. As they have developed in their performances, physical and vocal actions have become more expressive than the text.
We started doing exercises. This time nobody was using exercises. So it was very strange. It looked like gymnastics. It in part was also gymnastic because still I was at the very beginning of my theatrical experience, so I didn't know very much how to do. We were autodidact. Many inspirations we got from books. And of course, we interpreted what we read or we saw, pictures, illustrations, photos. And this slowly sedimented, stratified in a form of knowledge, which in 1968 seemed to be a new way of being an actor when the youth movement throughout the world was looking for new expressions.
Eugenio Barba had studied the work of Polish director Jerzy Grotowski, and like Grotowski, he had a new approach to the actor's vocal and physical expression. Barba was looking for new ways of connecting to oneself and to the audiences in a deeper human level than merely the social and intellectual. So Odin's exercises became constant studies, experiments, and training of body and voice in order to push boundaries and go beyond the everyday.
During the training, you learn to put in action your thoughts. So the space between thinking and action and doing it, it becomes shorter and shorter. So you are the action.
The training, I was quite slow. I think I worked nearly 4 years and trying to imitate what everybody else was doing, the colleagues from the Norway, the Norwegian actors, and they had all the bagage from Grotowski, but it was not our training. I felt that something was really missing. I asked myself, what is a dramatic action? So I invented ways of falling to the floor and I get up on my feet again. And it was like that the energy was transforming into something else. I could follow this flow. I found ways of sitting. I found ways of jumping. And these exercises had a flow. It's important to understand that I didn't come to the Odin Theatre and in day one I started to invent my own exercises. I had four really hard years before I started to do it.
You must find something in yourself when someone teaches you something. It's not like you should learn something that they say, because what they're showing you is saying, okay, here's something you can learn, but you have to find it yourself. You have to take it yourself and do something with it. And I mean, I think here for, I mean, Eugenio is that for us. I mean, definitely for me. I mean, I think it's a way of going beyond what you think is possible. It's a give and take of inspiration. And for the same time, I want to inspire my work. So he thinks, this is interesting. We can find something more in this. And that's what you want to find, this interaction, this wonderful possibility.
The way we work on a performance is very different for each performance. I would say that there are three big different approaches. One is a group performance that starts with Eugenio talking about a theme, telling some stories, giving some tasks. Another is a group performance that starts from the actor's work. And usually that is a kind of dance performance, a performance where Eugenio reacts to what the actors have prepared. And then there are the smaller performances, like the solos or two, three actors, which usually start from something that the actors want to do. But we can start with a text, without a text. We can start with a story, without a story. But it is very much a relationship that goes between Eugenio's and director and ourselves as actors. So in the first years, of course, we as actors are more dependent on Eugenio and what he says and his ideas. But then after 4, 5, 6, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 years, then the actors, of course, become much more independent and their proposals could be nearly a finished performance. And then Eugenio, a lot of his work is reducing, taking away, like cleaning and distilling.
At Odin Theatret, the subtext is often given by the physical action. And I will make an example from the performance Oxyrhynchus Evangeliet, in which I played the role of Joan of Arc. I had a scene. Was in Coptic, an ancient Egyptian language, a dead language.
Elegnosis dimitsi eloifeso.
Generally, when an actor does an improvisation and then he repeats it, the life of the first time is not present. Then you see a sort of shadow. But then he starts repeating and repeating. And then with time, the life comes back. So this is our here, the Odin experience, all of us. We are aware that the important thing after an improvisation is to preserve as many details as possible of this improvisation, because this flora of tiny things, poses, accelerations, hesitations, all this makes the behavior of the actor impacting, become a sort of a strong stimulus, a stimulation for the spectator.
Hiermit beginnt der Million erste Reise.
Odin Theatre took some of their performances outside the theatre building. They traveled to many different cities of the world and performed in streets and squares. their journeys where possible, they also met locals and indigenous people, shared their findings through performing for them, and in return, witnessed their hosts' traditional performances and rituals. This cultural exchange, which they call barters, still continues to this day and is maybe one of the main sources for creating their style, which is called theatre anthropology.
The way I've been defining theatre anthropology is the study of the human being in a situation of organized performance. Must be organized. So I see many performances. I see the théâtre, I see Chinese opera, I see pantomime in the West. And then I see that the forms are different. As a spectator, I can be very touched by théâtre, although I don't understand the language and I even don't share the religious belief. So, my question is, why, as a Westerner, as an Italian immigrant in Norway who has been studying in Poland, I get touched by a Persian theater? And of course, must be something with the actors. So my question is because these actors have a sort of gift from somewhere, which you can call talent, or there is something else? If it's not a question of talent, then it is a question of what? Of a know-how. And this know-how usually we call technique. If I take two hearts, you don't know if one belongs to an African or to an Asian. These hearts are just, and the same is for the stage anatomy. When you take an Iranian girl and she learns to sing Western opera, this is a question of technique. It's nothing to do with cultural identity or national identity. What decides the behavior of an actor is the style. You can have different forms, but the principle can be the same. And the principle which theater anthropology studies, the technical principles, have to do with stage presence.
Quanti mi era possibile, nella terra, nell'aria, nel mare, negli sguardi, nei gesti degli uomini. Mi amavi, sì, mi amavi.
We don't work with the method of Stanislavski. We don't start from emotions, we start from actions. So when we create a physical score, we start from an improvisation, and then a text is put on top of it. And then the actor starts to repeat and repeat and repeat, and the director starts to tune. But we never speak about emotion. You have to do it with more love. You have to do it with more anger. We don't do this. And of course, if I do like this, you don't think that I am friendly. And in the same times, I can feel inside my body like a string vibrating, producing what you can call an emotion, a feeling, a sensation. But it starts from the physical. So all the work with the training is also to be able to master the body at the point where you can decide absolutely, clearly, which action you do, with which intensity, and awake in the same moment a feeling, maybe with a voice, with a changing of the tone of the voice, with relaxing some muscles. You awake different sensation.
Epteriot maramo Antigoni, noi nomi timi saitimi timet.
Avoi epteve bolero comontres niatos.
Te canon piscopos polemos, tecne autos, te keptere.
Camaralicos marai! Davos
Eros te kebold marato polis in hello soano.
So the way you gesticulate, you move, you compose your image, your physical signs, reactions, already gives to the spectator certain information. Then also the voice. I can use the sonority, not the semantic, the meaning of the words, but the way I speak. I can speak like this. I can speak like this in such a way that you have a feeling that I am again irritated or starting to be impassioned for something. So also the sonority gives information. So already you hear two languages which the actor hears, in addition to the words of the author.
Wie man mit es gebet nüt oben sangun, wecken wir oben, flamme felles gebel of armen, efter Christians politiske is, wo wir es melte, die was am ange, a wie anne, a anne, po brein, vor wurden sie erkelbe, Ah, den Kelve, med blomsterbær, med folkemusik, med beatmusik, med nye måder at klæde sig på, med nye ord.
Katten. Directing. Dialogue. Being alone. Secret. It is easy to die. It is not easy to live.
Many of the things which people consider as aesthetical or artistic decisions from my side, a vision about theater. It is only the consequence of limitations, obstacles, obstructions, which we had in trying to create performance, which had a sense for the spectator.
At Odin Teatret, when you arrive, you get 1/4 of the salary. After 1 year, you get half a salary. After 3 years, you get 3/4 of a salary. After 4 years, you get a full salary. And you get the same, I mean, everybody get the same salary at Odin Theatre.
The relationships, when you do this profession, do not last a long time. I didn't want this to happen. I found that these young people had been my teachers in reality, and therefore I have tried to keep them. Of course, it was not easy, because human beings, they want to go where there is more life and more inspiration, more stimulation. Therefore, I had to transform this place in a very stimulating place which could satisfy and even foresee what they want to do. And this has also kept the people here.
I think this is Eugenio Barba, because he's really what we call the primus motor. And there are many things that we can share in the creative process, you know. Sometimes we come to him with material that we have prepared, but he's the one that chooses. He's the one that directs, and he's the one who takes the responsibility.
If I want to be an actress, there's no other place I would like to stay. I think we have the best director that you can find today. I think you don't have a better. And he has been like giving us part of the year. We have some months to do other things, so we can go out and then we come back and can like feel maybe the wanting to continue the work. And I think that is very clever.
We have been allowed to be different, and this has been allowed by the director. And we have, I think we have even been challenged to go in that direction.
I think it's the capacity of changing. Changing also means that the motivation to be together changes. It can be in the beginning that you want to learn. Then it can be the possibility of creating. Then it becomes the motivation which comes from giving, from teaching, from giving to other people.
The tradition of the transmission of the experience is typical of Odin Theatret. From the beginning, we have been doing workshops. And then actors started to write books. And then we started to make DVDs, film, with our work demonstration in order to spread the knowledge. Because this is a way to achieve immortality.